The Market Theatre is in Hitchin in Hertfordshire. So we're a small fringe style venue, presenting all our own work and producing all our own stuff throughout the year. It started back in 96, and it started was a project that the artistic director Kirk Foster sort of did alongside his teaching work. He is a sort of director teacher of theatre at various drama schools and colleges locally, and he started it along with a group of actors to create something in Hitchin that would complement the nightlife of Hitchin. And the group of actors that put it all together were all professional working actors at the time, and it was a nice thing for the actors to have outside of other works. Yeah, and it was lovely is that you see all sorts of actors here, all ages, all some that have done a lot of TV stuff. And actually, for people who do television work, this is really nice because it gives them their theatre fix. Over the last 13 months, it's been a roller coaster, I have to say. I mean, that sounds really cliche thing to say, but it has been a real roller coaster of emotions. We locked down in March, and we thought naively, like everyone did, oh, it'll be 3 or 4 weeks, we'll probably be open by latest June. And this was in what, March, wasn't it? March 2020. And we thought, well, June we'll probably get back up and running again. We had we have a big tour that goes out to about 30 theatres around the country in November and runs until the end of February. And we thought, well, that'll be fine. That will be fine with that, because by the time we get there, we'll be, well out of the way of COVID. So all of that was our thoughts. And in that time, we've gone through sort of risk of closure through not getting a cultural recovery grant the first time round. There was no reason given. There was a generic letter that we got from the Arts Council. So it was all handled by the Arts Council. And it was a generic letter that just said, but it was in a roundabout way saying, you're not culturally significant. We don't really know. We had lots of discussions with them afterwards. We tried to get more detail, but they said there's just too many organizations. They can't give us more feedback. But they did say to us, please go for the next round. Then we had a huge influx of donations through a crowdfunding campaign we did. So yeah, we went through all of what we just before Christmas as well. Just before Christmas, we got a notice to say that we were going to get sort of warning, really, that this was going to happen. And we had this planning application went in from our lovely landlord. And yeah, that was great to have that added to everything. So yeah, all of a sudden our future here became very uncertain. So you've just come through everything and you think, right, we've kind of survived this. I think we'll be all right if we can open, March, April, May. But yeah, to then get that suddenly thrown in, it was a real curveball. So the local community got very quickly behind the raising their objections to the planning application. And we had, I think it was over 200 objections to the planning application. Plus, we had local councillors, all of the local councillors said no, put their sort of word in. Yeah, I definitely think all theatres like us, theatres that are independently run, have all struggled in exactly the same way, no matter what their size either. What I saw from the sort of cultural recovery grant point of view, I suppose, in terms of people getting funding, it did look very much like the first round went to bigger theatres, in a sense, or the more established, and looking at sort of regional venues, the more established regional venues. Having said that, I think it's all relative because they've got a lot more overheads. They've got a lot more staff to pay, a lot more people who work there, that are full-time employed people. I'm hoping that there's a sort of boom in sales once people get the confidence to go back to theatre. And I think the biggest challenge that we're going to have, and all theatre's going to have over the next few months, is gaining people's confidence and getting people to come back and feeling safe in that environment. Because, like any concert or cinema experience or anything where you're sat in an audience, people have got used to keeping their distance from each other. So the idea that people want to sit next to each other is a very odd concept. So the idea that you're going to go into a theatre and sit next to people, with people behind you, in front of you, squeezing past to get past them to leave, and all those things, it really is, it's going to be a challenge, I think, for theatre going forward to get people back in, not because they don't want to come back, but because it's an environment that could feel unsafe.
I think I read a report recently that said UK theatres worth something like 2 billion or more than 2 billion to the UK economy each year. So it just shows you how important it is for the whole country and really important that people come back to it.
I really hope in a way that people appreciate live theatre when it kind of returns. I mean, it hasn't returned yet, so it's hard to know, but we had a little glimpse back in September last year. We opened with a one-woman show, but the ones who did come, their reaction was amazing. The sort of joy that of coming to see a live show, I've never really noticed that before. You take it for granted when you work in theatre. You go and do the show. When you're in a show, having been in shows, you sometimes get a bit blasé about the fact that there's an audience watching you. You just sort of, you're doing the show, if you've done it for a while, and you forget that there's people in there that have paid money and that's their night out. It becomes sort of a given that that's the situation. But when you've not had it for a while, it's quite emotional when you see people returning to the theatre and their reaction when they walk in the door and when they leave the theatre after the show, because they've seen someone doing a show live. And that's kind of what I hope. I think I'm hoping that the people appreciate coming to the theatre much more when they do return. And hopefully, you know, people will support it, you know, more going forward, because it is still a relatively small amount of the population that go to live theatre on a regular basis, I think.